So the question comes up usually is, what's the difference between default and dedicated EPS bearer? So if you're familiar with the way UE gets attached to an LTE network, then the default bearer, which is established, which carries the IP connectivity, that's your default bearer. And any other additional bearer which will be set up in addition to that default bearer will be termed as dedicated bearer. Now, having said that, that is the case if you're having purely a data session. And you can see in the screen as well, the default bearer is set up. And then you can see dedicated bearer set up in addition to default bearer. However, when it comes to voice and data, let's say you are having a voice over LTE call in addition to having a default data session bearer, then in that case, which will be the two default EPS bearers? So for UE, which is having data session as well as a connection with the IMS network for voice, there will be a default bearer for connectivity to the packet switch data network. And then there will be another bearer carrying IMS connectivity, and that will be considered as the default bearer for IMS connectivity, usually which is QCI5. So remember the context of the question. If someone is just asking about the data session, then yes, the default bearer is the one which is established default, giving IP connectivity. If you are considering about data and voice session, then in that case, the default one will be QCI5 in addition to the default EPS bearer, which is established in case of data session. Having said that, the dedicated bearer in case of voice over LTE will be the one which is carrying voice traffic QCI1 bearer, that is only established whenever voice session need, whenever it arises. So in short, the bearers which give you the IP connectivity to the network, those are default bearers. Any other bearers added in addition to those IP connectivity bearers are termed as dedicated EPS bearers.